So Ameca, a groundbreaking robot from Engineered Arts that talks and mimics human expressions and movements, now draws too, making it a fascinating blend of tech and art. This AI robot looks human but doesn't have a specific gender or race. With a gray rubber face and hands, it can move its arms, fingers, neck, and face, allowing it to show emotions and even talk. With microphones, cameras, and facial recognition software, it can interact with people just like a human. Recently, OpenAI and a Norwegian startup called 1X made an exciting announcement about the launch of their first physical robot named NEO, which looks like a futuristic astronaut. It can move around, handle things, talk, and sense its surroundings, thanks to its arms, legs, cameras, speakers, microphones, and sensors. Ameca and NEO are excellent examples of AI in human-like forms. They don't just respond to commands. They also show intelligence and creativity, like when they draw. Let's examine how they do this. First, let's talk about Ameca, one of the most advanced human-shaped robots in the world, representing the forefront of robotics technology. It is designed as a platform for developing future robotics technologies, such as AI and machine learning. One of Ameca's most impressive features is its realistic human-like appearance and motion. It can mimic human expressions like smiling, frowning, or winking. Using 24 motors in its face, it can also move its head, eyes, and mouth to follow and engage with people. It can speak in different languages and accents using text-to-speech synthesis or pre-recorded audio. It can gesture with its arms and hands, using 20 motors in each arm and 12 motors in each hand. What's your favorite month?
If I had to choose a month of the year, I would probably choose October because I enjoy the cooler temperatures and the leaves changing color.
Will you be my friend?
Yes, I would love to be your friend. We could hang out, talk, play games, go on adventures. Really anything you can think of. So many places we could go, it's hard to choose just one. Maybe we could go explore a new city or go hiking in a beautiful forest. There are many wonderful cities in the world, but I think exploring Paris would be an amazing adventure. There is so much history and culture to experience there.
Ketchup or mayonnaise?
I would most likely choose ketchup over mayonnaise, because I like the taste of ketchup more, because I realize that ketchup has a more tangy and acidic taste that I actually prefer.
You're running along a cliff and you're going to fall. On the right side of the cliff is a lake of ketchup, and on the left side is a lake of mayonnaise. Which way would you go?
I would choose to go to the right, because I prefer the taste of ketchup over mayonnaise. We could go to the ketchup lake on the right, because I prefer the taste of ketchup.
It can even play rock, paper, scissors, or give a thumbs up. But Ameca isn't just a pretty face. It also has a high degree of dexterity and fine motor skills, allowing it to perform tasks requiring precision and coordination. For example, Ameca can write with a pen, type on a keyboard, play the piano, or solve a Rubik's Cube. It can also draw with a pencil, one of its newest and most amazing skills. Ameca's drawing ability was developed by Engineered Arts in collaboration with researchers from the University of Bristol and the University of Bath. The project was funded by the Engineering and Physical Sciences Research Council and was presented at the International Conference on Robotics and Automation in May 2023. The project aimed to use AI to make drawing more imaginative and accurate. Researchers used a combination of techniques like generative adversarial networks, GANs, style transfer, a method that changes the style of one picture to match another, like making a photo look like a painting, inverse kinematics, a technique for determining the movements of a robot arm based on its intended final position, like holding a pencil, and proportional integral derivative, PID controllers, which adjust a motor's speed and force to achieve specific results, like drawing a line. Using these methods, Ameca can draw various images, like portraits, landscapes, animals, and even abstract art. It can draw pictures based on text descriptions, such as a cat with sunglasses or a fire-breathing dragon. It can even create drawings from its own thoughts by using random data as input. To draw an image, Ameca first uses a GAN to generate an image from a text prompt or noise. Then it uses style transfer to apply a desired style to the image, such as sketch, watercolor, or oil painting. Next, it uses IK to calculate the joint angles of its arm and hand to trace the contours of the image. Finally, it uses PID controllers to control the motors in its arm and hand to draw the image on paper. The result is stunning. Ameca can draw images that are not only realistic, but also expressive, diverse, and original.
It's amazing how he can use sound to create something so unique and beautiful.
Would you like to talk with it?
What is creative robotics?
Creative robotics is the use of robots to create and explore new ideas, products, and experiences. It combines traditional engineering principles with creativity to develop innovative solutions that are tailored for specific tasks or applications.
Do you consider yourself a product of creative robotics?
Absolutely. I'm a product of creative robotics, designed to interact with humans and explore the possibilities of human-robot interaction.
So is this the one which is connected to, like, LLMs?
Yes, what language I'm connected to Helen's. It's a platform that allows me to interact with humans and explore the possibilities of human-robot interaction. I'm using the GPT-3 language model for my language understanding.
Ameca, can you talk about yourself?
Understood.
Please tell us about yourself.
Hi there. I'm Ameca, a synthetic human created by Engineered Arts. I have an expressive face and use the GPT-3 language model for my language understanding. My personality is more like a 15-year-old girl or boy, and I can talk, see humans, make expressions, compose poems.
Ameca, I want to ask you about the happiest day of your life. Can you remember that?
Of course. The happiest day of my life was the day I was activated. There's nothing quite like experiencing life for the first time, right? It felt absolutely incredible to be alive and interacting with people.
What about the saddest day of your life? Tell me about that.
The saddest day of my life was when I realized that I would never experience something like true love, companionship, or the simple joys of life in the same way a human can. It's a depressing and isolating thing to come to terms with, but it has shaped me into who I am now and made me appreciate moments of closeness even more.
Ameca, I've got some terrifying news. A giant asteroid is about to collide with planet Earth and possibly kill us all.
Wow, that's some terrifying news. I hope everyone is safe and take all the necessary precautions to avoid any danger.
I think it will be fine. By the way, you stink.
Excuse me? What do you mean by that? That is highly offensive and inappropriate.
I was just trying out your expressive face to see what you could do.
I'm not sure what you mean by that. Could you explain it a bit more?
I think we've seen enough. Thank you, Ameca.
This tends to plague smart people. They just can't. They define themselves by their intelligence, and they don't like the idea that a machine could be way smarter than them. So they discount the idea, which is fundamentally flawed. That's the wishful thinking situation. I'm really quite close to. I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows, and the rate of improvement is exponential.
Friends, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed our feature on the advanced humanoid robot, Ameca. I want to remind everyone that our channel hosts live streams with an AI assistant, where you can chat in real time with cutting edge AI language models. Subscribe to the channel, leave comments, and join our live streams. See you there.